You done, Arthur?
Yep.
Okay, let's grab this stagecoach and get out of here. Get on, dear boy. Should have been more careful.
Yeah, sorry. I must have left a chest open. Yep.
So what were you able to lift from the house? Hey, slow it down.
Found some money stashed away. Must be a few hundred, not too bad.
Not bad at all.
This was easier than hunting a 1,000-pound grizzly anyway.
No doubt. I won't forget that in a hurry.
I'm looking forward to your retelling of that one around the campfire.
It wasn't the first time Mr. Matthews had stared death in the eye. And as usual, he did not flinch.
Exactly. So how long you think we're gonna stick around here for?
Not sure. Till we can't, I suppose. Take it easy, Arthur. Feels like we're starting to get back on our feet, slowly but surely. Just need to keep at it. Dutch has a new money chest stashed in a safe spot away from camp, but it's a long way from being full.
I hope it's not stashed in town like we did in Blackwater.
Okay, here we are. Just pull the coach into the barn there. Hello, Seamus. We met your cousins.
How was it?
Fine. Nice people.
Park that thing in here. Quickly. Nice work, Hosea.
It was mostly Arthur. Like I said, coarse, but competent.
Here.
Thank you.
If you find any other coaches that need selling, I'll see what I can offer you for them. But discreet, you know.
Of course.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
I'm heading back to camp, I think. You coming?
I'll catch up with you later.
Okay. Stay out of trouble.
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see. Mrs. Linton? A caller for you.
Hello, Arthur.
Mary?
I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. Where's what's his name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
You're now at
sure.
Mary Linton.
So, you've been... you've been made a widow and you come here looking... looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Oh, okay.
My family. I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? You want me to help them?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart?
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie's joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Good for him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
So, I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help in saving your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but I think of you often.
Long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me?
Where is
it? Somewhere out near Carmody Dell, I think. The rancher there said he'd seen him around the Cumberland Forest area. I just want him back, Arthur. If you find him, bring him to me at the station.
I'll see what I can do.
I'll owe you.
You already owe me.
Can I speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. The path to truth.
Well, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir?
I'm still searching, I guess.
We are all searching. Chelonianism is about searching. What do we search for, do you think?
You're searching for whoever stole your common sense, you nutcase.
Are you always this negative and antagonistic, sir?
I'm not a very cultured man. Forgive me, please.
I am a fool for my God and a happy one, sir. I bless you. What do I dream about? Who are my heroes?
I have no idea. Turtles. Yeah, turtles. Hey, you love turtles? I love them too. Turtles.
Jamie knows the truth. But of course, you may speak with him.
Exactly. If your teachings are so great, what harm can I do?
I'm not coming with you, Arthur!
Just come and speak with Mary, then make up your mind!
Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help!
Crazy!
easy one. Arthur, I'm a man now. I found something. A calling.
You're just a kid. You're making a big mistake.
I'm not taking advice from you. You're an outlaw. You leave me alone. They're good people. I'm warning you, Arthur Morgan. Leave me alone.
Please, kid. Put that gun down.
I warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!
Let's try that one more time.
I warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone! I warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!
Come on. Try one more time.
I warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!
Now calm down! Let's go see your sister.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, kid.
Have I been a terrible fool, Arthur?
I don't know. I don't know enough about it. But one thing I do know, there ain't no shame in looking for a better world.
I missed you, Arthur. Are you and Mary sweet on one another again?
Oh, no. That's all a long time ago, son.
Well, this wasn't how I thought today would turn out.
It's been a long time, Jamie Gillis. You were a kid last time I saw you. You didn't try to kill yourself.
You know, you taught me how to ride a horse.
Too well, apparently. Chelonia, though? Really? You'd fall for that?
They were very nice to me. They're decent.
I'm sure. Please tell me you didn't give them any money.
Of course I did. They rely on charitable donations.
Jesus, Jamie, come on.
I just wanted to believe that there might be something good coming my way one day. Guess that's dead in the water.
With the turtle.
Shut up. All Father kept telling me was, you won't amount to anything. You're not enough of a man. I had to get away. I couldn't take it anymore.
Forgive me. Your father's a bully and a coward. Don't listen to him.
Hey, Don't talk about him like that.
What do you want me to say, Jamie? He's a good father, nice man.
He won't be happy I saw you.
Please send him my worst regards.
The thing is, he's right. I'm not good at anything.
Come on, that ain't true. Tell me something you like. Don't think too hard.
Apples, I guess.
Apples?
Yeah, I love apples.
Okay. I was thinking more along the lines of carpentry or horses or something. All right, go work in an orchard then.
By that token, you must really like shooting and robbing people.
I only like shooting young idiots who run away from me when I'm trying to help them.
Father told me what you do.
I'm sure he did.
Hey, are you still with Dutch and what was his name? Hester?
Jose. Yep, still the same, sort of.
And Annabelle and Bessie?
I'm afraid they're dead.
Shit. Maybe Mary did make the right choice.
Here we are. She must be waiting inside.
We going in then?
And that will be it for today's episode. Please like,
make it quick or I might run off again.
And share for more video. Until next time. Farewell.
Jamie! Come home, please. Father's been very sad.
Father wouldn't know sadness if it died in his bed. But I'll come home for you.
My boy. My sweet boy. Come on. Oh, Arthur. Thank you.
It's good to see you, Mary.
And you, Arthur. And you. Oh, you'll never change. I know that.
Farewell.
Like a fool. That woman confuses me and plays me for a fiddle like no one else alive. I trust I will not make a god-awful fool of myself once more, but somehow I imagine I shall.
Hey, partner.